The NBA MVP award has been hotly debated. You can continue to yell and scream, but make one of the cases for these three. The finalists announced today, no real surprises here. Joel Embiid averaging a career high in scoring. His 28.5 points per game are the most by a center since Shaquille O'Neal in 2001. Embiid is the first Sixer MVP finalist since Allen Iverson back in 2001 when he won the award. Nikola Jokic is the odds-on favorite according to Caesars. Jokic was top five in the NBA total points, rebounds, and assists, joining Elgin Baylor. And Wilt Chamberlain is the only player to accomplish the feat. No Nuggets player has ever won the award, so maybe some history down the line. Steph Curry was the third finalist, and he's looking for his third MVP award. He led the NBA with a career-high 32 points per game. His seven games with 10 or more three-pointers set a new single-season NBA
record. Has told awards voters ballots are due today. I heard you, Mark Broussard. So, yep, it is also time for the Jump's regular season awards. Let's start with best season. As I have said many times, I believe that the MVP should go back to what it was earlier in the league's history, awarded to the player who's simply the best guy in the league. The guy, if you absolutely had to win a game to save your house, who would be your first pick? Meanwhile, though, we should also have an award for best season. The guy whose stats this season jumped off the page. And again, we've had leagues like the NHL, like Major League Baseball, like the NFL, change their awards to recognize that these are two different things, who had the best season versus who's the best player. And as for who had the best season in 2021, well, here's what LeBron James thinks. Take a listen.
You know, we just got to play to the best of our ability. We got to play Lakers basketball. We got to defend at a high rate. We're playing versus, in my opinion, the MVP of our league this year, and Steph. So, we got to be, prepared for everything that they have. They got championship DNA as well, they've been there. They know what it takes and what it feels like to be in pressure games. So, we got to be ready for that opportunity and for that pressure.
He's so smart. He's so smart.
It's so annoying.
He's just buttering him up.
Like, look, and he's telling the truth.
Right.
But he didn't have to say
you
that.
You think this is all a ploy that Steph is considering his extension this summer?
No. Steph legitimately.
Everything he said was true, too. LeBron said was true.
What is he buttering him up?
Because it's like you're about to play a dude in the postseason. Like, you don't want to boost their heads up. You don't want to give them anything good or bad. But it's just like, look.
Okay, so. If we all lived in my world and we separated out MVP, which we'll talk about in a minute, is who's the guy if you had to win one game, who would you pick first? That's separate. This season, who had the best season this season, either statistically or just do you think helped his team the most this season?
Steph Curry, without a doubt, is not even close who had the best season, right? Like Matt brought it up. Steph answered so many questions, and Warrior fans would get sensitive. What are you talking about this? It's like, yo, Steve Kerr came out and said it last year. Mm-hmm. Hey, we're not going to go push Steph out there and play him 40 minutes like he's James Harden or Giannis. Like, mm-hmm. No, the way he plays, that's just too difficult. Mm-hmm. But this season, he comes back, no Clay again. He goes out there and plays a ton of games and carries this team. They had a ton of talent, but carries this team averaging 30-something points and leading the league in scoring, answered questions that, even his greatness still needed to be answered. Could he just carry the load? And he did that.
I mean, Steph's my guy, too. I also have Joker and Embiid in that conversation. But, it's considering what Steph lost. You lose KD, then you lose Clay. And then this is, again, the year he was supposed to be exposed. And I said at the beginning of this season, we're going to get to see Steph's version of James Harden basketball this year. They play different, but as far as you being the first, second, and third option, that's what Steph was this year, and he definitely didn't disappoint.
Look, I think there's a case on either side, right? Steph and Draymond made this case. He said, look at the team we had last year. He said, there's been some changes, but it's basically the same talent. But without Steph and the record mm-hmm. he said that we had versus the record with Steph playing. But with Jokic, the numbers are just off the charts, yeah. guys. Mm-hmm. The efficiency, the advanced stats only make him more of a candidate. If you're looking for more of that narrative vibe, what he did with this team after Jamal Murray went down, the fact that he played in every single game mm-hmm. in a season where, look, it wasn't everyone's fault if they were out for chunks of time, but it happened, right? And his defense, which had been a weakness before, he made a concerted effort to change. And when I had a conversation with him a few weeks ago, we keep talking about this new slim look. It's not just making him, more energetic and a little bit, he said, just a little bit faster. But it's really helped him defensively. It's had a lot more energy and a lot more on the defensive side. So I understand both cases. it interests me that players have pretty consistently talked about Steph. Now, that is a separate conversation,
though. Not MVP, people.
Than MVP in this, in our world, in this discussion. So to me, this should go, this should kind of call back to how the MVP, before we had access to all of these stats, there was kind of a consensus on, hey, who's the best guy in the league right now? If you had to win a game tomorrow, who is the person you would pick? And for a long time, it was Michael Jordan, but he didn't win all those MVPs. Mm-hmm. I think he should have in those years. And if we had a separate award for best season, we wouldn't have seen the split that we have. So take it to today. And this is me basically asking you guys, who is the best player in the NBA?
Go to Matt first.
Man, you are a coward. Matt, if you had to just, if like we saw Damian Lillard and that fan earlier said, I'm counting on you for my house. Right. And we said, well, if you're counting on someone for your house, Dame is a good guy. If you had to save your family, save your house by winning a basketball game.
Lord. Kevin Durant.
That is who you'd pick.
Taking Kevin Durant.
Okay.
I think he was on the verge of slowly claiming that before he tore his Achilles. I think he was on a tear coming off those finals. The way he's been able to come back this year off this type of injury and still like he never missed a beat, still consistent, still efficient, still probably the most scary player in the game. So if I'm going to take one player, I'm taking Kevin Durant to save my family.
Oh, this is tough. And I like my words don't count nearly as much because I am associated with LeBron James. But like to me, he's still the best player. Because you were saying like Kevin Durant, he was on the verge. He didn't get there.
Didn't get there.
The year he gets hurt, LeBron James wins the MVP or wins the finals MVP and wins a championship. And he's still the reigning finals MVP. Right. And so prior to the injuries to him and Anthony Davis, they were the number one ranked defense. They were the number one ranked team in the league. It looked like he was about to get his fifth MVP. Mm-hmm. So if you tell me the most valuable player, the best player on the planet, until someone gets past that verge, then to me, it's still LeBron James. He's got to hold the title until someone just surpasses him in a way. And you don't just TKO the champ. You got to knock out the champ.
You got to finish the champ.
And I don't think anybody, there's been some TKOs, but there hasn't been anybody knock out the champ yet.
Do you guys think, as I do, that this should be separated out a little bit more?
100% I agree.
I think it'd be more excitement, you know, more stuff to talk about, but definitely because there's a big difference. And I think we've all made great points today why there's such a difference between these different categories.
Right.
Well, the Chris Paul and Steph Curry, the Chris Paul and Steph Curry kind of, you know, situation is like they're best players, what they've meant. Are they the MVPs? But you could still be the best player on the planet, not be the MVP or vice versa. So, it should be separated because the criteria just keeps growing and changing and then advancing. Stats bring it all in.
Well, I will say this also, that when we talk about the award as it is now, because sadly I don't get to make all these decisions for the NBA, the word value is something that there is not really consensus among the voters on what that means. Some guys will literally just run down all of the stats for you, and then they will criticize people who talk about things like leadership is like, oh, you're just a narrative voter, and that's a media construction on the most popular coastal teams. That's not what a narrative actually means, and I'm not going to get into that. But what I will say is this. You don't get to just say it's cancel culture when we hold people accountable, right? That's a thing. Yeah. We don't get to just say it's the narrative when we talk about leadership. That's a thing. Mm-hmm. So when there are guys who are being considered for the MVP as it is now, I will say as a voter, one of the things I take into account is what do you do globally for that team? How much does that team change if you are taken off it with the production of the other guys, with the effect on other guys, the vibe about whether they go to war or not? And I will say, Nikola Jokic is a great example for me because to me, value includes leadership. What he did after Jamal Murray went down, that is value in that category to me. And that's not narrative
and
or
Monte
storytelling.
And Monte Morris and Will Barton, like he's going to be the MVP.
Agreed.
There you go. All right. Producer Steve says go to break. We will do more fun stuff after it. We'll see you in a second.
Whatever, Steve.